गुड मॉर्निंग डियर बीएससी एग्रीकल्चर सिक्स सेमेस्टर स्टूडेंट. टुडे इज माय सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ योर कोर्स पोस्ट हार्वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड वैल्यू एडिशन ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स. टुडे आई विल टेक द लेक्चर ऑन फ्रूट्स रैपनिंग एंड चेंजेस अकरिंग ड्यूरिंग रैपनिंग प्रोसेस. एज वी ऑल नो व्हाट इज फ्रूट रैपनिंग. फ्रूट रैपनिंग वर्ड आपने सभी को सुना होगा. जैसे ह्यूमन बींग्स में डिफरेंट फेजेस आते हैं, जुवेनाइल फेज, यंग फेज, मैच्योरिटी फेज, ओल्ड फेज, देन डेथ. लाइक दैट इन प्लांट्स ऑल्सो देयर आर डिफरेंट फेजेज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट, लाइक जुवेनाइल फेज, वेजिटेटिव फेज, देन रिप्रोडक्टिव फेज, देन सेनेसेंस एंड देन फाइनली डेथ ऑफ द प्लांट. सो फ्रूट रैपनिंग इज द प्रोजेनेटिकली प्रोग्राम्ड स्टेज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट ओवरलैपिंग विद द सेनेसेंस प्रोसेस. When the fruit ripening process comes just after maturity, it overlaps with the senescence. Means just after fruit ripening, senescence occurs. So we can say it is a genetically programmed stage of development. A fruit is said to be ripe when it attains its full color and aroma. For example, आप mango को देखिए, banana को देखिए. जब कच्चे रहेंगे तो वो बिल्कुल green color के दिखेंगे. देन लेकिन जब वो इट विल स्टार्ट रैपनिंग, जब वो रैपनिंग इसका प्रोसेस शुरू होगा, देन आप लोग इसके फ्लेवर को फील करिएगा, एरोमा को. देन यू विल नोटिस द चेंजेस इन द कलर. दीज आर द चेंजेस दैट अकर्स ड्यूरिंग फ्रूट रैपनिंग. देर आर मेनली टू टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रूट्स यू मस्ट बी नोइंग, दैट इज द क्लाइमेटिक फ्रूट्स एंड अदर इज नॉन क्लाइमेट्रिक फ्रूट्स. सो वॉट इज क्लाइमेट्रिक फ्रूट्स एंड नॉन क्लाइमेट्रिक फ्रूट्स? You can understand in the easy term. Climacteric fruits are the fruits which goes on ripening even after harvest. For example, banana and mango. जब आप इसको तोड़ भी लीजिएगा तो उसमें ripening process खुद ब खुद start होगी. लेकिन जो non-climacteric fruits होते हैं, once they are separated from the plants, जब आप इसको plant से तोड़ लीजिएगा, then it is not going to ripen anymore. So it has to be ripened on the plant itself. That is the non-climatic fruit. So what is the physiological process that affects? क्यों ऐसा होता है कि कुछ fruits हम लोग तोड़ भी लेते हैं तो भी पकते हैं, लेकिन क्यों ऐसा होता है कि कुछ fruits को हम लोग allow करते हैं, जैसे citrus, grape. These are the fruits that is non-climatic fruits. क्यों हम लोग इसे पेड़ पे ही ripen होने देते हैं? Because there are some of the physiological changes that occurs in the plant. These are the changes, that is respiration rate, increase in the ethylene production. Mainly the ethylene production governs which fruits is the non-climatic and which fruits is the climatic fruits. In climatic fruits, you can notice that there is a, when the initial formation of ethylene starts, there is a burst of ethylene formation. So when you separate it in the from the plant, the ripening starts itself only. For example, अगर आप एक कागज के टुकड़े को जलाते हो, ये धीरे धीरे जलना शुरू होता है, लेकिन then it again there is a burst of combustion. So like that in climatic fruit also there is a peak level of ethylene formation. For example, in climatic fruits, a best example is banana, mango. Other than this, apple, apricot, avocado, bear, fig, I have given in the table also. You can see it from there. And non-climatic fruits are cherries, citrus, grape, lychee, olive, like that. Pineapple also is the best example of non-climatic fruit. It is also a cam plant. So you can see in the figure also, this I have shown you, climatic and non-climatic fruits. This I have shown you in the figure, that is when you keep, agar aap ग्रीन बनाना, कच्चे बनाना को ऐसे सोर्स के पास रखते हो, फॉर एग्जाम्पल पके हुए एप्पल के पास आप उसको रख दीजिए, यू विल नोटिस दैट सडनली द राइपनिंग स्टार्ट्स इटसेल्फ इन द बनाना. सो इथिलीन इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड अ गैस हार्मोन. इट इज अ नेचुरल प्लांट हार्मोन विच इज गैसियस इन नेचर. इट इज अ इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट स्टूडेंट्स. सो वेन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ इथिलीन स्टार्ट्स, it goes in the banana fruits and the it initiates the burst of ethylene formation. It binds with the ethylene receptor and the ripening of the banana fruit starts. So what are the changes that occurs during a ripening process? There are many changes which occur during a ripening process which I have described list wise, that is cell wall changes, starch, organic acid, color, flavoring compounds, ascorbic acid, phenolics, amino acids and protein, dispersion, transpiration and ethylene evolution rate. So I will be discussing first is the cell wall changes. What is the cell wall changes? When अगर आप कच्चे मैंगो को देखते हो और पके हुए मैंगो को देखते हो, यू विल नोटिस द चेंज इन द टेक्सचर ऑफ दैट आउटर स्किन. सो व्हाई डज इट हैपन व्हेन द राइपनिंग ऑफ अ फ्रूट स्टार्ट्स? बिकॉज सेल वॉल इज कंपोज्ड ऑफ द पैक्टिक एसिड, सेल्युलोज एंड हेमीसेल्युलोज एंड अदर नॉन सेल्युलोजिक पॉलीसेकेराइड्स. देर इज अ मिडिल लैमिला ऑल्सो विच इज रिच इन द पैक्टिक पॉलीसेकेराइड. So when the ethylene formation starts, the activity of the different enzymes increases. That enzyme is hydrolase, pectinase, kinase and amylase. These are the enzyme which becomes active, and thus the cell wall changes starts during ripening process. Second is starch. During ripening process, you will notice the conversion of starch into the शुगर. कच्चे मैंगो को खाइएगा तो ये इसका टेस्ट बिल्कुल अलग लगेगा, लेकिन अगर आप पके मैंगो को खाइएगा तो इसका टेस्ट बिल्कुल अलग लगेगा, ये मीठा लगेगा. व्हाई व्हाई इट इज ड्यू टू द कन्वर्जन ऑफ स्टार्च इनटू द शुगर. थर्ड फैक्टर्स विच अकर ड्यूरिंग द राइपनिंग प्रोसेस, दैट इज द ऑर्गेनिक एसिड. ऑर्गेनिक एसिड्स आर द एसिड्स दैट्स आर ऑर्गेनिक इन नेचर एंड प्रोड्यूस इन साइड द प्लांट. दैट इज for example malic acid, tartaric acid, citric acid, these are all the acids which are produced in the plant. Then the color. When the ripening start, you will notice the degradation of chlorophyll into the colored pigment, that is anthocyanin or carotenoid. So during ripening process, green pigment converts into the colored pigment. So I have shown you in the figure also, that is how during the ripening the green color of banana is changing into orange, yellow color, then during the senescence it is going to convert into the black color, which is a non edible. Then the flavoring compound changes occurs during the ripening process due to the production of specific flavoring compounds. You will notice the flavor when you eat a ripened fruit. So these compounds are mainly the esters, alcohols, aldehyde, acid and ketones. Then the ascorbic acid. These are also the ascorbic acid, which is called the vitamin C. It is a naturally occurring ascorbic acid in fruits. A reduced amount of ascorbic acid will you notice in palm, stone and berry fruits at the time of harvest. Then the phenolic changes. Phenolic content of most fruits declines from high level during early growth to low level when the fruit ripens. Then the amino acid and pectin. Decrease in free amino acid, which often reflects an increase in protein synthesis. So during the senescence process, the level of free amino acid increase. I have shown you by the figure during the fruit ripening how the physical condition and chemical changes occur during the fruit ripening process. For example, that is the green color changes into red, hard outer layer converts into the soft layer, the sorry nature converts into neutral, chlorophyll is converted into anthocyanin pigment, pectin is converted into less pectin compounds, and acidity of the fruits becomes neutral in nature, and starchy nature, starch converts into the sugar due to the activity of amylase enzyme. These are the enzymes which becomes active during the ripening process, that is hydrolase, pectinase, kinase and amylase. During the ripening process, respiration rate also increases, then transpiration rate increases. You must be knowing these two terms. So during the ripening process, I have told, that is during the ripening process, ethylene becomes active. Ethylene is also called the ripening hormone or gas hormone. So how the formation of ethylene starts in plant? Here I have shown you that how the formation of ethylene occurs in the plant. Ethylene formation takes place from an essential amino acid that is called methionine. Methionine is a sulfur containing amino acid. So L-methionine is the main precursor of ethylene formation, which converts, methionine is converted into SAM. SAM is S-adenosyl methionine. Then by the action of ACC synthase, ACC formation occurs. ACC is 1 aminocyclopropane, 1 carboxylic acid. So by the action of ACC oxidase, ethylene formation takes place from ACC compound. Here you can also see that is how the ripening is taking place from in the tomato. During ripening, cell wall structure is changing, pigment accumulation is occurring, flavor and aromatic volatile production of compounds takes place, and conversion of starch to sugar takes place. Rise in respiration. Respiration is required for the release of energy and substrates for the synthesis of several organic compounds required in ripening process. So in climatic fruit, there is an increase in respiration called climacteric. This climacteric peak is obtained very fast when temperature is relatively high. So you can say that when the temperature is high, the ripening process is fast, and when the temperature is low, the ripening process is slow. So it is directly related with the temperature. So and during the respiration process, the oxidative breakdown of the complex material takes place. Now different ripening method. If you want to ripen, suppose you have the unripe fruits, for example banana and mango, it is not ripened and you want to ripen it. So what are the different methods you will go for the ripening of these fruits? So most widely used compound is calcium carbide. It is most widely used chemical that hastens the ripening. It releases the gases, that is acetylene gas. But there is one demerit in using this calcium carbide, that it affects the nervous system by reducing the supply of oxygen to the brain. So it is now banned under 44AA of PFA rules 1955. It is not recommended to use the calcium carbide, but illegally it is being used. So when you will talk the most safe method of ripening of the fruits, the most safest method is the use of artificial ethylene. That the use of artificial ethylene, the commercial use of artificial ethylene is done by the ethafone and ethereal. Ethereal is nothing but the 2-chloroethane phosphonic acid. It is recommended to use these artificial ethylene for the ripening process, and it is the only permitted to use under FDA regulation because it is the natural gas which is produced in the plant. But in case of calcium carbide, that acetylene gas is produced, which is not a natural gas, but this ethylene is a natural gas which is produced inside the plant. So for the artificial ripening, we recommend the ethylene. As a commercial form of ethylene is ethereal and ethafone. Application of ethafone promotes degreening also. So during the ripening process, that green pigment degradation of chlorophyll occurs and it changes into the anthocyanin pigment. Here you can see in the figure that degreening in citrus. Degreening is mainly performed at a temperature of 15 to 25 degrees Celsius, because at this temperature best color development occurs, and we have to carried out that ripening process in a ripening room, and this process takes place at 2 to 3 days. It approximately takes 2 to 3 days to complete that degreening process. Carbon dioxide level should not exceed to 1%. Anti-graining was also recommended in citrus because it also improves the skin color, which is accepted by the market. So too, for the market acceptance, that in citrus degreening is followed. The major factor which affect during commercial ripening is temperature control, relative humidity control, ethylene gas and adequate air circulation. Means if you are going to ripen the food fruit artificially, you have to consider these four factors for the proper ripening process. For the artificial ripening of tomatoes, we will recommend the 20 to 21 degree Celsius temperature and 90 to 95 degree Celsius relative humidity. Ethylene concentration is 100 to 150 ppm we generally recommend, and there should be air ventilation of 1 air change per 6 hours or twice per day. So when you want to, if you are going to transport a fruit produce to a distance market, so if you are going to transport it in the unripe stage, and if you want to ripen that produce only at that place where you are going to transport it, so it is the best method to use the artificial ethylene to ripen it. Because if you suppose aap transport kar rahe ho yahi par aap paka ke fruit ripen karke aur transport kar rahe ho dusre jagah pe for other countries, so it is going to deteriorate also the fruit quality, also it is going to deteriorated. So इथिलीन अगर आप वहीं पर जहाँ पे कंज्यूमर है इसके वहीं पर आप इसको रैपन कर रहे हो, सो इट इज़ गोइंग टू इम्प्रूव द शेल्फ लाइफ ऑल्सो एंड क्वालिटी ऑफ द फ्रूट्स. वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू टेल अबाउट दैट इथिलीन, यूज ऑफ इथिलीन गैस इज नाउ अ मल्टी बिलियन डॉलर इंडस्ट्री इन फॉरेन कंट्रीज लाइक USA, जापान. दे आर यूजिंग दिस beneficial use of ethylene for the ripening of the fruits. Next, how to minimize ethylene production and increase the shelf life. Suppose हम लोग को fruits के shelf life को बढ़ाना है, हम लोग को ethylene के production को घटाना है, तो what are the different methods to minimize the ethylene production and increase the shelf life. So as I have discussed earlier that fruit ripening is directly related with the temperature. So first point is temperature regulation. As I told that with increase in the temperature, rate of ripening increases. ये आप लोगों ने खुद day to day life में notice किया होगा, गर्मी ज़्यादा रहती है तो फल बहुत जल्दी बर्बाद हो जाते हैं. So you can notice in also that is, so what we are going to recommend. So we would recommend that storage of fruits at low temperature, because at low temperature the rate of respiration decreases, so thus the ethylene production is also decreased, so obviously the shelf life is going to increase. Now the next is regulation of storage temperature. If you natural atmospheric air is conductive for the ethylene production, so if you are going to decrease the oxygen concentration below 5% and increase the CO2 concentration between 3 to 10%, it will delay the ripening by inhibiting the ethylene formation, thus ultimately the shelf life is enhanced. We are also using the method of you by removing the ethylene from storage house using ozone or UV radiation. These are the methods which is now becoming popular. For chemical method to increase the shelf life of fruits and vegetable, ethylene absorbent is also being used. A most popular ethylene absorbent is KMnO4, potassium permanganate, at a rate of 100 ppm. Just go through this slide. Use of auxin is also recommended to increase of shelf life. Why auxin increase the shelf life of the produce? Because the ethylene is antagonistic to the action of auxin. So when you are going to use the auxin, it is going to inhibit the formation of ethylene. So ultimately the shelf life of the produced is enhanced. For vegetable also, it is being preserved by the use of lactic acid. For avoiding exposure to ethylene, we have to use the adequate ventilation and use of ethylene absorber. As I told earlier, that is potassium permanganate is used in inert pellet form. That is commercial form is ethizorb. It is marketed in the form of ethizorb. There are various biosynthesis inhibitor also which inhibit the formation of ethylene. The most popular is MCP, methyl cyclopropane. It is formulated in the form of powder, and when it is mixed with water or buffer solution, it releases the gas 1 MCP, and it is applied just immediately after harvesting of the produce. It is available in the market in the form of ethyblock. It is used on the ornamental crops, and second one is smart fresh. It is preferred on the fruits and vegetables. Thank you.